We did last lesson. Very, very good lesson. Last time we learned the days of the week and we also learned how to count to 10. So today we are going to do the months of the year. You pronounce this janvier, 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 January, janvier. February, février, February, février, février, février. Now for March, which is the month we are in at the moment. For the month of April, we say April. The month of May, it is almost exactly the same. On dit le mois de mai. 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 Mai, 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 mai. Le mois de mai. Now for the month of June. The month of June is said juin, 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 juin. July, juillet, juillet, juillet. Now for the month of August. August, August, we say this one is a little bit tedious because it is spelled a août, a août, but it is pronounced out. The A is a silent A. You put it on sleep. Out. Out. Of these months are very, very similar, and this next one is not an exception because it is September. And in French, September is said septembre, septembre, septembre. So, as you can see, the only difference is you reverse the E and the R. Other than that, it's the same word. The same principle applies for the next one. So it is the month of October. And in French, we say octobre, which is again the same word, only you reverse the E and the R. Octobre. Next is November. In French, we say novembre, which again, you only reverse the E and the R, and otherwise it's the same, and it is the same for the next month. The next and final month of the year. The next month is the month of Christmas, December, and you say in French, décembre. Décembre. Again, as I said before, same principle. You reverse the E and the R. And because in French there are accents sometimes on these words, the E has an accent. Accent aigu. And so yeah, this is December, and that concludes the month of the year. Make a little song out of the months of the year, which we just learned. Janvier, février, mars, avril, mai, juin, juillet, août, septembre, octobre, novembre et décembre. Can sing along with me. Janvier, février, mars, avril, mai, juin, juillet, août, septembre, octobre, novembre et décembre. Janvier, février, mars, avril, mai, juin, juillet, septembre, octobre, novembre, décembre. Now, I will teach you the seasons of the year. So there are four seasons, or there are to be four seasons in a year. Climate change, global warming is changing that, but officially there are four seasons to a year. So we have which one you start with, because where is the beginning? I mean, when it's winter, there was an autumn before that, and after that there is also a spring. Where do you start? Do you start in January, because January is technically the first month of the year? I don't know. So I was born in spring, so that's where I'm going to start. So after spring we have summer, then we have autumn. In American English, autumn is called fall. And then we have the all famous winter is coming. Okay, so spring in French is called printemps. Printemps. Notice that the P and the S are silent. Summer is called été, again with des accents aigus. Autumn or fall in French is called automne. So again we have two very similar words. Automne. The M and the N are pronounced just N. The M is silent. So automne. I'm sure that in some provinces of France they do pronounce the M in automne. But where I live, we don't pronounce it. So for the next season is winter. We say hiver. 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 And you will notice that in the word hiver, we do not pronounce the H, it's a silent H. We pronounce the word as if it started with an I, but it starts with a H, a silent H. Okay, so now that we have learned the months of the year, and also the different seasons, I'm going to construct some phrases with those words in them. So I'm going to write them down and then we will pronounce them together. So we are going to read these phrases together. Janvier est en hiver. Now you repeat after me. Yeah. Very good. Very good. Now, février est en hiver. Your turn. Février est en hiver. Very good. Very good. En mars, le printemps naît. This is pronounced naît. Le printemps naît. Very good, very good. Avril est au printemps. Very good, very good. Now for the month of May. May est au printemps. May est au printemps. Very, very good. En juin, le printemps meurt. Et l'été pointe le bout de son nez. That's a hard one, isn't it? Okay, take your time. Take your time. En juin, le printemps meurt. Et l'été pointe le bout de son nez. Very good, very good. Juillet est en été. Juillet est en été. Very good. Remember what I said about the pronunciation of this word? Août. Août est en été. Very good. En septembre, l'automne arrive. En septembre, l'automne arrive. Very good, very good. Octobre est en automne. Novembre est en automne. Novembre est en automne. Very good. And the last one. Et en décembre, l'hiver arrive. Winter is coming. Very good, and that is very good. You are learning very well. You are a super good class. So for the next lesson, what I want you to do is to revise. Basically, just go go over what we've already learned. So that would be the days of the week. The months of the year. How to count to 10. If you could just revise that and learn it off by heart, then we'll go from there. So thank you for joining me. I hope that this lesson has been very helpful, very instructive for you. And I will see you next time. Bye bye!